In vocational services, we run projects that help poor students in gaining CNC skills that will do this to help these poor students. Some pictures of what we are doing. Individuals from various streams. These are typically men or women who, through their hard work and integrity, have attained leadership positions, practicing professionals, sportsperson or community change agents, and who are therefore rolling your award to outstanding individuals among the youth who excel of cyclone or government employees such as the committed neighborhood postman. This is recognized eminent persons such as Mrs. Sarojini Varadappan, Professor Junjunwala, Mr. Syed Sailendra Babu on stage here today. I thank you all for coming and joining us for this event.
Thanks, Mohan Deva, for highlighting all the activities of the club and the vocation.
And I think it's apt for me to say that while we're recognizing an achievement, it would be incomplete not to.
Thank you very much for the opportunity and pleasure for being here in this very, very joyful event, and I think a very important event, because I think it is not easy to get awards. At the outset, my hearty congratulations to the awardees, Mr. Srinath Narayanan, a chess prodigy, the Young Achiever Award, Dr. Jayashree Gopal, the Vocational Excellence Award in the field of diabetology and endocrinology, Mrs. Aruna Shairam Lifetime Achievement Award for her contribution in the area of musicology. I think you have heard all of them, and you certainly know that they really deserve, probably they deserve more than what they have received today. I hesitate to comment on the achievements of the awardees. I can only say that they are individuals who can be considered role models and to be respected by one and all for their contribution and achievement. I especially say respected because I think it is very, very important for every one of us to learn to respect every human being. It's an opportunity and honor to have the pleasure of presenting the awards to them. The Rotary Clubs as service organizations have existed for many years and known for their community service projects targeted towards the underprivileged in areas of medicine, education, disabled, and many more. Every one of them is a real need, and the general public and the beneficiaries should be grateful for the service for the service organizations. What is service? The immediate response to the reference to service to me is always Swami Vivekananda and Bhagavad Gita. Service, service above self, service without expectation, without expecting any reward, that is Gita and that is Swamiji. Service for service sake is the highest motive in life, and Bhagavad Gita says, action is a duty, fruit is not their concern. In my perception, this service must become part of one's life, everyone's life. We should inculcate the ethos of service in the minds of children so that it is not something that they do as part of social work at school, but become a part of their routine day life. Every Rotarian, I believe, should accept this as a mission. It is also gratifying that excellence in one's area of work is being recognized by the Rotary Young Achiever Award, Lifetime Achievement Award, and the Vocational Excellence Awards for their commitment to their work and those who are considered role models. It has been my view that any award or recognition should not be taken or accepted as just a recognition. Just as every right carries with it certain responsibilities, the achiever must also accept additional responsibilities. The achievers have become role models because of their commitment to their work and the values and principles they have practiced. They must create more and more committed individuals. They must create more role models. India needs more role models. And the message they must pass on is, infinite striving to be the best is man's duty. It is its own reward. That was Mahatma Gandhi. The Rotary and all service organizations and all achievers must involve themselves in creating high values and principles in school children, college students, workplaces, communities, and one must be aware of social justice. Recently, I was amazed to read in the Hindu, the Japanese school children are provided with a dusting rag and are expected to clean their own classroom and surrounding environment in the school. I'm sure many of you have been to Japan. I think it is one of the cleanest countries that I've ever seen. I think it is amazing. The children say they are proud of doing it. And they say when the teacher tells them, you're good, they are prouder still. So they continue to do. They keep their place clean. It's not that, you know, I still remember my first visit abroad when I went through Switzerland and then on to Canada. I wrote back to my mother and told her, you don't have to get anything clean. You can sit on the road and eat. That was the cleanliness that they had practiced. I think we should learn to do that. I think cleanliness, I think we are told is godliness. But where are we clean? I think this is something that the Rotaries and all service organizations can take up. Achievements and awards are recognition of one's contribution to society. Medicine is considered a noble profession, a work of service, serving lives whenever possible by giving the best of our ability, and when saving is not possible, relief and comfort. Service is part of our duty, and it is indeed a unique opportunity and privilege to practice it to the maximum extent possible. That's what I have already said, to do one's best in whatever work you do, it is its own reward. I congratulate Dr. Jayashri Gopal for having been chosen for the Vocational Excellence Award. I take the opportunity also to say that the medical professionals have a great responsibility wherever, in whatever area of work, and as general practitioners or specialists. To me, these have always inspired me to more action. Rockefeller said, I believe that rendering of useful service is the common duty of mankind, and that only in the purifying fire of sacrifice is the dross of selfishness consumed and the greatness of the human soul set free. And Gitanjali Rabindranath Tagore said, this is my prayer to thee, my Lord. Strike at the root of penury in my heart. Give me strength lightly to bear my joy and sorrows. Give me strength to make my love fruitful in service. Give me the strength never to disown the poor or bend my knees before insolent might. Give me the strength to raise my mind high above daily trifles. And give me the strength to surrender my strength to thy will with love. Please, thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you very much, madam, for your thank you and very inspiring words. Thank you very much.